गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू अरोरा ऑनलाइन क्लासेस डियर स्टूडेंट्स टुडे आई एम विद अ न्यू पोएम फॉर यू एंड दिस पोएम इज नो मेन आर फॉरेन नो मेन आर फॉरेन एंड इट इज बाय जेम्स कॉकअप जेम्स कॉकअप वाज अ वेरी फेमस पोएट ऑफ तमिल लैंग्वेज and actually this poem basically based on universal love and brotherhood we are human being and we have our own needs we have our physical needs we have our emotional needs we have our social needs so actually there is no basic difference regarding the needs of the people the poet says that since we are human beings and being human beings we have the same feelings we have the same emotions we have the same sentiments we have the same basic needs we need food clothes shelter house education It doesn't mean that only the people of India need all these things. There is no such boundary. The people of entire world have the same needs. We need water, we need air, we need food, we need shelter, we need house, we need education. Secondly, our emotions are same. We express our love, we express our joy, we express our sorrow, we get angry, we have hatred. So we all are same. And the boundaries have been made by the human beings themselves. Basically, there is no distinction, there is no difference. But in the society, we see the difference on the basis of caste, on the basis of color, on the basis of religion, on the basis of languages. So we have the barriers of the language, barriers of caste and community, barriers of religion, and that is why we judge the people according to their religion, according to their caste, according to their community. And they all are man-made. God has not made any caste. God has not made any community. God has not made any religion. God hasn't made all these things. We have made it. So the poet says that before being the people of a country, we are human beings. And being human beings, our needs are same. So there is no need to spread hatred. There is a greater need that we should live in harmony. We should live peacefully, and we should live happily. So this is the title. No country is an alien. No country is foreign. All are same, because we all are. We means the people of this world. Without any distinction of caste, community or nationality, we are not foreign, we are not estranged, we are one. And we are one, and our only religion is, we have the only one religion, and that is humanity. Humanity is the greatest religion. And we should respect our fellow beings. And we all are the children of God. So if we are the children of God, we should love each other, we should support each other, we should live peacefully, we should live in harmony. Harmony means to live peacefully together, mil jul kar ek saath rehna. They are our brothers. So the poet reminds us that under all different dresses, people belonging to different countries are physically the same. And the land on which they live and in which they are buried is the same everywhere. We have the same land. We are born on this land. We do our duty, and when the time comes, we die. We die on this land. We are buried on this land. We are cremated on this land according to our religious belief. Hindus are cremated. Their dead bodies are burnt. But our Muslim brothers, Christian brothers, their dead bodies are not cremated. Their dead bodies are buried. So basically we are same. So this is about universal brotherhood. Let us go further. Have you ever thought of some people as a strange or other countries as foreign? We have many ways of thinking of other people as different from us, as them. They may belong to a different country. They may speak a different language. In this poem, however, the poet reminds us of many ways in which we are all the same. So there are many ways we all are same. For we are human. We all are human. So we all are human. We have the same needs. We have the same feelings. We have the same emotions. We have the same necessities. So we are not different. So this is about universal love. Love for one. Love for one and all. Sabhi logon se pyar. Because we are human beings and we are the children of the same God. What does the poet say, James Kirkup? Remember, no men are estranged, no countries foreign. Beneath all uniforms a single body breathes. Like us, the land our brothers walk upon is earth like this in which we all shall lie. The poet gives an emphasis, gives a stress on this line. Remember, he gives a message to all the people, who he tells the people of this world, all human beings, that no men are estranged, no men are alien, no countries are estranged, no countries are different. Beneath all uniforms, we have a single human body, be it in America, be it in India, be it in Japan, be it in Pakistan, be it in China, be it in Switzerland, anywhere. Under the different uniforms, under the different sets of life, people belonging to different uniforms means people belonging to different culture, people belonging to different religion, people belonging to different caste, people belonging to different communities, people belonging to people speaking different languages, following different faiths, religion and beliefs. This is uniform. We are same. We have the same human body. And we all need breath. We all need air to breathe in. Is there any country where people don't need air to breathe in? Or do only the people of India breathe in or breathe out? No. Everybody, each and every one of us breathes wherever we live. So breathing is needed. Without breathing, we cannot survive. We can't live. So everybody, each one of us needs breathing. We need air to breathe in. And without air, we cannot survive. The same thing is with water too. We need water. All the people of this entire world, not only the people of India, not only the people of China, not only the people of, Switzerland, not only the people of Europe, not only the people of America, not only the people of Japan. Wherever we are, we all are human beings and we need water, we need air, we need food, we need dresses, we need education to survive in this world. So our needs are same. We are same because our needs are same. We are same because our feelings are same. We are same because our necessities are same. We all human beings need air, water, food, cloth, shelter. So we all are same. We are born on this earth. Like ours, the land, our brothers walk upon. Our brothers means people belonging to different religion, cultures, communities. They are our brothers because they are also the children of God. And we all are the children of God. We call God by different names. We call Ishwar. We call him Ishwar. We call him Bhagwan. We call him God. We call him Allah. We call the same supreme power, the same divine power, by different names. But we all are the children of God. And that is why there is no basic difference. Is earth like this in which we all shall lie? The poet says we are born on this earth. We play our role. We do different kinds of activities. We do farming. We run business. We run schools, we run colleges, we set up factories, we manufacture things, we need science and technology. So people of the entire world, the whole world need all these things. We are same. We are born on this earth and we do all sorts of activities, we do different kinds of activities. And then the time comes, then we leave this world forever. We depart from this world forever. So we shall lie. Lie means buried. Lie means buried. Means we are born on this earth and we die on this earth. So death comes to one and all. And it is a universal appeal. It is a universal fact. If we have life, we have death. No one is immortal in this world. Now, stanza 2. They too aware of sun and air and water. The poet says, we all are aware of sun. We all need sunlight. We all need water. We all need air. We means be the people of this world. We need all these things. There is not a single country where the people don't need water, where the people don't need air, where the people don't need food, where the people don't need clothes. It's not like that. Be the people of this world, belonging to different caste, religion, category, isn't it? Following different cultures, civilizations, faith and religions. We all need all these things, air, water, sun, are fed by peaceful harvest, by war's long winter starved. We have to face difficulties. We all have to face difficulties. We all have to struggle for our survival. We have to face eventualities. We have to face hardships. We have to face troubles. We have to face the ravages of war and battles. And wherever war takes place, it brings destruction. And it takes place everywhere. There is hatred everywhere. And just because of this hatred, there is enmity. And just because of enmity, the situation of war occurs. So the poet means to say that we all have to face the ravages of war. Because war is destructive and it is destructive for all. We all have to face the winters, the sufferings of winters. We all have to face the problems like, you know, hunger, starvation. We all face. No one is an exception to it. So we have to face war. We all face war. And war brings destruction to all. We have to face hunger. We have to face starvation. We have to face all other problems too in the society. No one is an exception to it. Their hands are ours, and in their lines we read a labor not different from our own. Their hands are ours. They are the people of different countries don't have the different hands. That is our hands, because they are our brothers. As they are the children of same God. We are the children of same father, and our father is God. So their hands are ours. And in their lines we read a labor not different from our own. They have to work for survival. And we all have to work for survival. We all have to labor hard. So we all need to work hard for our survival. And we have to work hard for our comforts of life. We all have to work hard for the joys of our life. So I mean to say, we all need labor. Do only the people of India work hard? And does only India have factories, industries? No, it's not like that. Wherever there are industries, wherever there are factories, wherever there are manufacturing units, everybody has to work. Be it agriculture, be it factories, be it industries, be it business, everybody has to do all these things. No one is exception. Remember, they have, stanza 3, remember, the poet says remember, means don't forget. And this is for all. This is for the people of the world. So his message is for the people of this world, not for the people of a particular country, because he says that no one is foreign. No one is different. We all are same. Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and a strength that can be won by love. He says we take rest. We have eyes, they have eyes. We work hard, they also work hard, because they are our brothers, and we all work hard. And when we get tired, we sleep at night. A strength that can be won by love in every land is common life. Life is common everywhere. We all need love. We can win over hatred. Grana, nafrat. We can win over enmity. Satruta, dushmani, hostility. So we can win over any evil of life, any ills of our heart and mind, like anger, like jealousy, like hatred. So how can we win over hatred? How can we win over jealousy? How can we win over anger? By love. And everybody needs love. So by love we can win everyone. So life is common that all can recognize and understand. Everybody can recognize and understand the theme of love. We all are human beings. We all have love. We all have love. And we can win over our fellow beings by love. So only love is the solution to our problem. So the poet wants to say, we should live peacefully, we should live in harmony, we should not fight with our fellow beings. We should not spread hatred, we should not express jealousy, we should not be jealous of others, because others are not others, they are ours. So why to be jealous of, if they are ours? So, dear students, no men are foreign. We all are same. We all are same because our needs are same, because our feelings are same, our work is same, our sentiments are same. And this is applicable for everyone. Though we are divided on the basis of cult, on the basis of religion, caste, communities, they are man-made. God has not made caste. God has not made community. God has not made religion. God has not made the boundaries. We have made the boundaries between two countries or between the continents. This is the boundary between India and China. This is the boundary between India and Pakistan. This is the boundary between Pakistan and Afghanistan, we the people have, according to our needs, we the people have made this the boundaries. At the same time, we are divided on the basis of culture. There are people who belong to Christianity, there are people who belong to Hinduism, there are people who belong to Islam, like that. But actually, our religion is same. And what is our religion? That is humanity. We all are humans. So, dear students, thank you very much. So, today I have taught you up to 3 stanzas. And I'll teach you the rest of the things in my next class. Till then, take care, be happy, keep learning. Keep practicing. Thank you very much.